Guys, come on!
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the center of the earth.
Working with Brandon is so much fun because he's such a big lug of a guy. He's so great on camera. He's so great to work with, to collaborate with. He knows this genre, and he's better than anybody at this sort of shadow boxing where he's pretending to interact with something that isn't there.
They're everywhere!
Sean, don't we get to the batting cage?
After all that's said and done, when I watch the raft sequence in this and remember how miserable we were for 5 days standing underneath these rain machines, you know, battling invisible fish, like sucking wind like you would not believe, it's all worth it. It's all worth it. To see the audience watch this movie is such a pleasure for me because you see little kids and adults reaching out trying to grab the birds and other things or jumping under their skin when the dinosaur shows up.
Yeah, it's not that easy, especially when you have to be running from something like that and all you have is a green screen. You definitely have to rely on your imagination and also the director to kind of give you a mental painting of what that's going to look like, so you're not just reacting to your idea of a dinosaur, you're reacting to that thing. Have you ever seen a dinosaur before?
Josh is a professional actor that acts like he's been doing it for 30 years, and he was 13 when we shot the movie, and he arrived every day knowing what to do, asking all the right questions, making suggestions that were appropriate for his character, and really having a great time. I had a wonderful time working with him.
Come on, boys. Want to be home by sundown.
Anita, this was her first big Hollywood movie, and I feel like she was really a find because she's beautiful, she's a wonderful actress. She's the great counterpoint to Brendan in that she's the serious, she's the straight man in the movie, and she wears the pants in the family, I like to say. She's so much fun to watch, and over the course of the movie you see the dynamics change as the three of them kind of become almost a family unit.
Getting closer.
Well, just watch your step there. Snipers is deceptively treacherous.
I took great joy in this female character that is sort of driving the action of the movie. Hannah is somebody who's grown up in a sort of a treacherous highlands of Iceland, and the three of us go to explore the highlands of Iceland and find ourselves trapped in this cave and start to kind of accidentally find ourselves closer and closer to the center of the earth.
And they gotta find a way to pool together and get out. And while they do that, lucky for us as audience members, we're able to watch it and be immersed in the story. No, I take that back. Included in it, if not even feeling like you are a character in the movie. Even more so, you're practically the star of the movie when you go to see Journey to Center Earth in 3D because it comes to you. You are in it. You can see on the horizon. It's an experience, is what it's about.